This might go just to upgrade those void rays with a speeder grid. It actually makes them an excellent harassment unit, but more probably, this might be either a mothership that is a stupid unit that should be in this game, unless it is changed, because it looks awesome but says that it is stupid, just stupid. Or it might be a source of chaos that are plain awesome, and I would love to see those guys. But oh man, this might be a problem. Sprado, as you can see, he's going for his Starkers. There's a single sentry, not enough in my honest opinion. And he's also going for upgraded Colossi. Really? Colossi versus, well, just a tip, Sprando, Colossi do not counter void rays. I mean, I know that Colossi are cool in PvT in some matchups, but PvP when your opponent is playing void rays, not the best idea in the world, may I put this this way. So, actually, yeah, oh my piece of hellcake, this is actually going to be us. Carrier spam, and I forgot once again how to speak in English, but oh well, it does not matter. The first carrier is already crowd boosted, and it is coming away. It is going to warp right in front of the target, and it is going to get right into the battlefield, and the first upgrade for it is already on its way, and it's going to be awesome. Oh man, I can't wait. But as you can see, the army from Sprob is also very reliable. There's a lot of those Starkers, and I cannot count, so I'm not going to count them. There's also a single sentry, couple of Zealots as a mutual, and also Colossus that is going to be useless. A second Colossus mate is going to join the battlefield, but still, well, I'm not really sure why Sprado decided to make Colossi. Well, against those Zealots, okay, they might also do decent, let's say, against those Starkers, as they do not have that much of a life or ammo. But in PvP, Colossi, not the best idea, unless your opponent is really going for a Zealous spawn. But besides that, nah, I do not think that this was really the best idea in the world. And a single problem, as I think the army, but it doesn't matter, as those armies are finally starting to fight each other. As I can see, Zealous got a little bit of guard with this encounter, and Sprado managed to get a couple of freakies. But the first carry is already on the field. He's got those 80 Deceptors that are right now firing upon those up enemies. Two kills already for the carrier, but he lost one single Interceptor, and as you can see, this battle is actually very even. But the thing that is just allowing Zealous to own his opponent are those sentries that are giving those garden shields to those Stalkers and sentries and voiders and carriers and whatever, that are just so important from the time. And actually, they are always so important. And another battle just right now occurring. Those armies are a little bit small, but the battle is still as tense as possible. And oh man, this looks amazing. Who is going to win? Apparently, Zealous is the one who is going to lose. But still, he got away with one of his carriers. And this is still a carrier. And if I would have to bet, a carrier is more awesome than those three Colossi and those three Stalkers. So it seems like Zealous is getting an advantage on the upper hand over here, as he's still making more and more of those carries, while his opponent is still going for the Colossi, and I have no idea why, but apparently he is. So as you can see, those Interceptors already got a number one upgrade for themselves, which is extraordinarily important, as those carriers, Interceptors deal really a small, very small amount of damage, and they need those upgrades to be able to tear through those the ammo, those Protoss tight units. But as you can see, another battle is occurring, and this time Zealous has got much more army than the army of Sprado. However, as you can see, still Sprado is losing his units pretty fast, only because of those carriers that are simply able to shoot their Interceptors and back off, However, one of the Interceptors is being stabbed out by those Starkers, but now it did go away, and right now it can go back onto the battlefield. A couple of Mitchells that has just swapped in, and it is going to deal some damage onto those Starkers if they choose to move in. But one of those Colossi already went down. I think this is the second Colossi that already went down. Is this encounter some more Mitchells on the battlefield? But they are not going to send the trust against those Colossi. Actually, they did, as another Colossus goes down, and this was a very, very even battle. But actually, Sprono has lost it by the other means I can express it. And whoa, that was epic. And as you can see, Sprono is in a hurry. He's got to make as many units as fast as he can, because his opponent has got three bases, and this gives Zeros a huge economy. advantage, and his foe doesn't break it, he's in a real bad shape. So as you can see, another bio fight is evolving, and whoa! Zerax has just let one of his carriers, and he's moving in with a couple of new shoots, aka Zeros, but this Colossus is actually way too close to the battlefield. It has the range upgrade, but it still got snapped out pretty easily, which is a big micro mistake on Sproul part. He's now trying to snap this carrier, but he's not. Yes, he is going to do so. Another carrier goes down. A huge loss for Zeras, but still, he's got the advantage, in my opinion, in the army wise. He's getting a charge upgrade, so those Zeras are just a little bit better as Mitchells. And he's also getting another attack upgrade for those carriers. So, one tip I would really love to give to Sproul right now: make some sentries. If they use the guardian sheets, those interceptors are just way less powerful. I mean, they lose two attack for every single interceptor, so there are three carriers, every single one is carrying 8 interceptors, so this is 32 interceptors, and they will just deal 2 damage less for each, so this would be 64 damage less dealt every time they attack, and this is actually, so every second they will deal 64 less damage if it would be a garden shield protecting those units from Spradon. So really, do not underestimate the value of the garden shields. And also, another way to counter those carriers is blink, which is all probably going to be researched at this Twilight Council. So as you can see, Sproul is doing the right thing right now to do but he's still continuing to make those Colossi really bad idea, in my opinion. I mean, they can't just pass through those Zealots if they are being microed correctly, but from the other side, really, they can be just torn to pieces by those carriers, and this, it might not be the choice that I would personally recommend. And whoa, this is a scary amount of carriers that we can see right now, and I'm scared myself. I'm going hard myself. Okay, sorry, I'm going to continue this video, guys, for the good of us. Oh, and I'm actually going to drink some more water. Actually, I'm not, I'm just that cool. I'm not going to drink any more water. I'm going to let my throat just get non-wet. What is the opposite of wet? Dry, and just, you know, it is going to be a horrible pain. As you can see, Zeros has actually used the force suit on this battlefield. I have no idea. First, why would the force suit used? Because the Colossi can walk over them and just crush them. Second, I do not think the Sproul had that many Zealots anyway. And thirdly, those carriers could still microwave from those targets. And quadrily, those targets could simply blink into those carriers to save them. And what else? Apparently, those suckers still did not manage to overpower any of those carriers, and this is GG right here, as Zeras is just going to, whoa, look at the amazing, beautiful shit effects on this Nexus that just went off, but oh wait, it was beautiful, I while it lasted. There's 2 Colossi, and actually 0 Colossi, I saw 2 dots over here before. They're probably just trying to do any damage to Zeras, but seriously, 2 carriers are just so much more powerful than 2 Colossi, and they really managed to kill them, no problem whatsoever. Those guys already have 2 upgrades to attack, now they are going to have the armor upgrade, so this is really a force to be reckoned with, and there's absolutely nothing whatsoever that Sproul could do about it. And yeah, this is a GG right here, right now, and Sproul is just trying to snap any of those carriers, but he does not manage to do so, and there we go, he has left the game, and whoa, this is an enjoyable cast, and we see the final last shot from this interceptor, looks cool upon this assimilator. So yeah, this was exciting. I really love this game. I hope that you loved it as well. So thank you for watching it. I'm Pantos of the Mighty Mixpower. If you joined my video cast, then please log in at your YouTube account and subscribe to my channel if you aren't super subscribed already, and comment this video cast on Gambling Please or YouTube. I really love those comments and really appreciate them. And yeah, that's about more probably all I wanted to say, and I just paused myself at the end of this video cast, but I think it doesn't really matter. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys online. Oh, by the way, thank you Zeros for uploading this replay for me, really appreciate it, and yeah, thank you a lot.